Okay. Let's get this show on the road. Just get my thing up, my video up my phone. I'll get the live stream on my phone so I can check and see the audio's good and whatnot. All right. Oh, my audio is still shit for some fucking reason. I don't know why. Look at the microphone. Is it one of these things? Let me lower down the game volume just to 40. Nah, sometimes they talk too low. We'll do 48 to see if that makes it a little better. Do that though. That's weird. Change it all. No, it doesn't seem like it's changed at all. Monitoring output, no. Monitor, could that be heard? Hello? Is this better? I think monitor output's a little better. Alright, fuck it. Hey, you just have to turn up your volumes really high if you want to, you know, hear me talk. But, like I said, I mostly let the games do the talking. Also got some ice cream on here. So we did Sly Cooper and the Thieves Raccoons, that's the first one. We platinumed the game actually, but we did not 100%, and I don't want to 100% that was it. Go fuck yourself. You expect me to do that? That's too much. I like the game, but I don't like those time segment challenges. So I think I do remember trying a couple of them. I got through some of them were ridiculous. So we're going to Band of Thieves, and then we'll go to Honor Among Thieves. These are my two favorites, because they changed the game big time, plus the graphics are a lot better. At least the models do. The graphics, all in all, were only slightly improved. Well, I say slightly improved, but the backgrounds got a lot more crispier and cleaner. But you'll see the models here in just a second. They look fucking good. Oh yeah. Let's make sure the music's all good. New game.
Breaker Alpha Foxtrot, this is the Wizard. Do you read me, Sitting Duck?
This is Peking Duck. I hear you, Blizzard.
No, Sly, I'm the Wizard, and you're Sitting Duck.
I read you loud and clear, Lizard.
No, I'm... Forget it, you're not taking this seriously.
Yeah, I'm not. Look, Bentley, I know this is your first time out in the field, but you've gotta loosen up. If we're gonna get to those clockwork parts, I need you on your toes. So in plain talk, what's your status?
Well, I've established myself in the basement, and I'm pretty sure I can rewire the service elevator if you can power it up from that security station.
Hang tough, pal. It might take some time, but I'll figure out a way to get up there.
Yeah, look at this. Already looks improvement. First off, his design's changed a little bit. He's got, instead of the backpack, he's got like a little pouch on his side. He's got some new moves too. That's a normal spin attack. I don't use it that much, but he's also got this. He's got an uppercut now. So yeah, oh, you gotta sprint, because you got sneak and sprint. So. And Banaki Kam's right stick instead of his other. Oh my God! Whoa. That's not good. I need to. Oh no. Where's the options? Much better. Oof. That was bad. What even tells me? Curio Museum break-in. Yeah, so the game just throws you right in, but this is obviously after the events of the first game, but apparently we gotta get the clockwork parts, because it's not over.
Okay, I splice the wires. Ouch! Hold on! There
and for the first time, you get to play as each member, and we won't do it right now, but we will get to play as Bentley and Murray. And there he is, look, he looks good.
Okay, let me at that security computer. The spotlights are offline. There goes the laser security system. I'm working on the security gate. Presto, all clear.
Thanks, pal. For your first time out, you did pretty well.
Oh, this operation is far from complete. Now that the lasers and spotlights are offline, Murray should be moving into position for your rendezvous. I'll stay here and provide computer support while you go on ahead.
Let's go.
Just take the long way around.
If memory serves, you need to jump and hit the circle button to run along ropes.
It's one of those coins. Oh. This is going to be a fun game to play. I'm excited for this one because I like this one a lot. Only a few missions I don't like.
Greetings, citizen. I hope you weren't harmed by my meteoropic entrance.
No, Murray, I kept at a safe distance.
Good. The Thunderflop knows neither friend nor foe, only destruction.
Yeah, could you maybe channel some of that raw energy into the security gate?
Of course! It is nothing before the Murray. Okay, all clear.
Oh, it looks like he's about to take a massive shit.
Another barrier stands before you. Fear not, I shall bend it like the truth.
Solid work, Murray. You're really in the zone.
My hulking frame is too much for that puny rope. You go ahead and unlock the doors from the inside. I'll be waiting in the hallway to help you carry out the clockwork parts.
Murray and Bentley changed a lot. Bentley was too afraid to step outside the van, now he's actually out here. Murray, he stepped outside the van. It was a weirdly like a coward, even though he should be super strong. Now he's a fucking badass. Fighting people's fists and shit.
I don't get it, Sly. The clockwork part should be here. This is all wrong. We need to pull the plug on this operation right now.
Oh, shit.
Freeze, Cooper.
Inspector Fox. As beautiful and unpredictable as ever.
Whereas you crooks are so predictable. You always return to the scene of the crime.
Crime? I haven't stolen anything. Yet.
Oh, really? Then who broke in last night and made off with all the clockwork parts? You've got the motive.
Someone already stole the parts?
Don't play dumb with me. It might not have been him, Carmelita. The method of entry and guard casualties all point to this being a claw gang job.
The Claw Gang?
Constable Neela, I allowed you to sit in on this stakeout as a favor to the Contessa. I really don't need any help. Oh, I think you might. Look at the facts. Facts? Sly Cooper is right here. I caught him red-handed. I'm just saying that there are other criminals in the world other than... Sly Cooper! After him!
Shit, time to go.
Hey, come back here, Ringtail!
Oh, jeez!
Wait up, boy! Jump, Murray.
It's time to go.
Freeze!
This wasn't part of the plan.
Yeah, well, this is where things get fun.
You can't run forever!
Run, Murray, run!
This is getting a little hot. You guys go warm up the van. I'll keep Carmelita busy.
You're all going to jail.
Pick me up at the rendezvous.
Jesus, cops everywhere.
Hold still!
No thanks, bitch. I'm getting the hell out of here.
Stop, thief! Hold still!
This is a cinematic beginning, though, I gotta say. Shit's going on.
Stop, thief!
With the cops and the gang driving away. Here they go again. That van's changed a lot too. Oh, not really. The wheels are just smaller now.
You can't run forever.
I'm heading toward your position. Jump in fast so we can get out of here.
Yeah. I'll find you, Cooper.
Her voice changed too. She had like a kind of Latina voice. Now she sounds like an American. Even Murray's voice changed.
Carmelita's just as angry as ever. She's really quite lovely when she's angry. And that Constable Neela, was a reference to the Claw Gang just a slip of the tongue, or an intentional clue? Either way, it's her only lead on the missing clockwork parts.
These scenes look a lot better now.
Clockwork. He was consumed with jealousy for the Cooper clan's thieving reputation. Is it inappropriate to refer to him as a monster? No, not at all. What kind of person stays alive for hundreds of years with the express intention of wiping out a rival's family line? Imagine the hatred fueling that first decision to replace his mortal body with soulless machinery. Ultimately, it did the trick. Clockwork lived on. He caught up with my parents, and I wound up in an orphanage. It's there that I met my pals, Bentley, the brains of our outfit, and Murray, the brawn. They turned out to be all the family I needed. 2 years ago, I thought I'd finished it. How naive to think I could so easily put an end to that kind of hatred. And now he's back. In pieces, sure, but the threat is real. Does the Claw Gang even realize what they've stolen? I don't know what's in my future, but I won't let it be a repeat of my past.
Save. This is a good episode. I love this episode. My favorite villain too. Let's check it out. The Black Chateau, I think it is. And that's cool too. We always see that every time.
I had to call in a few favors to get the goods on the Claw Gang's local operator. Dimitri, a sort of underworld celebrity, equally at home in high-class art circles and shady back-alley crimes. He was once a passionate young art student who worked hard to develop his own visionary style. Unfortunately, the art world wasn't quite ready for his kinetic aesthetic. So he gave them what they wanted, and started forging old masterpieces. His way of punishing those with bad taste. Dimitri now runs a nightclub on the west side. The thumpy music, colorful light shows, and a hint of danger lure in chic young patrons from far and wide. And it's here, hidden somewhere, where we'll find the clockwork tail feathers. What Dimitri plans to do with the clockwork part is beyond me, but those plans end tonight.
Here's the sad thing about this game that the third one improved upon. This is the only level where you'll get this nice little intro. The next several levels will not have this on an awesome intro of Sly running around to the hideout. The third one added that, and they did it well. It was amazing. And the fourth one, they just fucking forgot about it. This is the character select scene in the hideout. And here we can go and sell our loot. Yeah, you can collect loot and buy upgrades. So a lot. Now, Bentley and Murray can get a huge amount of stuff, but Sly can get a shit ton of smoke bombs for one of the better ones to have in this game. So, can't play as any of them, so I just took Sly out. Oh, and clue bottles are back. There's only 20 for each level, so I'm gonna grab them all.
I tell you, Bentley, it's gonna be a real pleasure robbing this nightclub.
I share in your enthusiasm, but before we hit the inside, we'll need to do a little reconnaissance work.
What do you have in mind?
I've installed this special antenna on the safe house to help with our first job, hacking into Dimitri's satellite array. The coordinates for the job start beacon have been uploaded to your binocular. Make your way to this position, and I'll give you a full briefing on our objective.
I'm on my way.
Sly, if you click the L3 button, you know, press the left analog stick.
Oh, 30, I'm
sorry. I'll beam some virtual markers into your feet When no markers are in view, use the right analog stick to move the camera and look around for them. Remember, the view is always better from the rooftops. Fascinating! The message you just found appears to be some sort of clue. I'll decipher it here in the safe house. In the meantime, see if you can find any more clues. The more I have, the easier it'll be to crack the code.
Yeah, these will lead to a special upgrade that I'm going to want. So I'll grab them now while I can. And there's already a person to loot. Yeah, pickpocketing in this game. Only Sly can do it. The third one, they act again and improve upon it, where everyone can pickpocket. Sly's second best pickpocket. Doesn't take that move. Yeah, this game really relies heavily on the stealth, by the way. Because I can get to fight enemies, but they're going to take lots of hits. And don't even bother trying to fight flashlight guards. It's not like the first game where those guys can go down one hit. Well, all of them did. Now those flashlight guards are tough. Not even Murray could take them on. Murray has a tough time with them as well. Well, he could take them down better than Sly or Bentley, but if you're gonna fight him with Sly or Bentley, you're gonna have to use some, you know, lots of, unconventional means. No, that's not the word. What word am I looking for? Fuck, I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh yeah, and you also have a health bar. Forgot to mention that. Take that, good sir, thank you.
Sly, I need you to hack into Dimitri's communication array so that we'll have access to his database.
How am I supposed to do that?
To start, you'll need to get to the top of that tower. Then reposition the satellite dish to point at my safe house antenna. If you want to climb on stuff, jump and hit the circle button to grab hold. Try climbing up that pipe.
Right. Jump and press the circle button to climb pipes. I'm on it.
We'll see a thing, bitch.
I've projected holographic markers near interactive objects like this satellite dish. When you're near these markers, press the circle button to use the object. Great, the first one's in position. I've uploaded the next waypoint into your leaf mask imager. Remember, click the L3 button to locate your next objective.
Any chance I see get a pickpocket, I'm going to try and do it, because that's good money.
Pressing the L3 button to find the last dish waypoint. from a rooftop. Sly, you can hold down the R1 button while walking to break into a fast run, but be careful, as this is sure to be loud enough to alert any guards in the vicinity.
Almost to the halfway point of these bottles. What was zeros and ones?
Nice work, Sly. I'm downloading from Dimitri's mainframe as we speak.
All in a night's work. So, where do we go from here?
Your next job is to break into the nightclub and take some reconnaissance photos of the clockwork tail feathers. To get inside, you'll have to sneak through an old wine cellar beneath town.
Okay. I'll head up for the cellar.
You're looking down at that. He's got actual fighting stance now. Okay, who else sees me? No one should be seeing me right now. These briefcases of money usually have a good amount of cash in them. Usually. I don't think I've missed a spot so far. I think I've gotten most of the spots. I played this game a lot, so I usually remember where all it's at. That bastard. Go away. Thank you. I do.
Keep looking. It's sure to be inside this place somewhere.
Breaking and entering is the name of this job.
Good to see you, little buddy. I guess the way through the wine cellar is guarded by those rats. Bentley thought you might like some help clearing them out.
Sounds like fun. You and me, back to back?
Totally. Outnumbered, fighting impossible odds. It's perfect.
All right, pal. Let's get to it.
Your voice changed a lot, Murray. Fucking used to sound like, okay, let's go Sly. And he's like, oh, let's go Sly.
Fear the Murray!
Yeah, he's gonna take care of most of these guys for me, so. Ouch.
Hold on, Sly. Let me lower those bars for you. There you go. To get over this thing, you'll have to double jump. Hit the X button to jump, then, while in the air, press it again to get some extra air time. Looks like you're on your own from here.
I'm used to it. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, partner.
And these guys, I can't take these dudes on. They're way too tough. Looks like a badass, so look at that gun and that drip that he's wearing.
These flashlight guards are too tough to fight head on. Crawl under the tables to sneak around him.
Shit. Whoops. I guess I won't take him on then. I'm going too ahead of the game pretty much because I know how to play this game, so. What? You didn't see me? This is bullshit. Go fuck yourself. Ooh.
That sneak attack slam move only fight with those rats, the sneak attack won't work. It's purely a stealth move.
Fight them. Okay, cool. Well, then you don't tell you to sneak if they're knocked down. Like with those little birdies chirping on their heads, then you can actually just take that move then. Please do not blow up the generator.
That generator seems to be powering the security systems down here.
I'm gonna get a better angle. When it comes to these ones, I don't know why I get so obsessed with that. I like to get a good shot of the baddies. Look at that walk he does.
That's our target, Dimitri, professional lounge lizard and international fortune. That should do it, Sly. Head back to the safe house and we'll cook up a plan of attack.
Recon photos are a grim reminder of what the modern thief is up against. Spotlights, stepped up patrols, the sum of it all renders a direct assault impossible. To solve this puzzle, I'm going to need some more intelligence. First, replace this bugged painting with one Dimitri has in his office. Once in place, we should be able to listen in on his communications. Second, if you see the boss, tail him. We might learn something from studying his movements. Once we've got a proper understanding of the operation, those clockwork tail feathers are as good as ours.
Those little slideshows got better in the third game as well. Almost there. I'll buy a smoke bomb first, so I can't play the deadly.
Hey Sly, you can bring up your binoculars by pressing the R3 button. You know, the right analog stick that adjusts the camera. Click it to look through your binoculars. They'll be useful for finding the new job starts I've placed around town. Plus, they'll let you read the job title. This forged painting with a bug. I need you to sneak into Dimitri's office and swap it with the original.
Nice. So we'll be able to listen in on his conversations.
Yes, I thought things might go more smoothly with an ear on the inside. Just be careful with the fine art. Take any damage and the painting's ruined.
Hold up. Spend that money. Ooh, gold. Nice, nice, nice. Yeah, Yep, so I can't get hit once with this thing on. There's lots of treasure you can get. I don't know if it's in, I think there's some in this level, not a whole lot though. But the later levels have treasure you can find around the map. Put on these little pedestals and pick them up, bring them back to the safe house without getting hit, and then sell it for a ton of cash. But then the later ones get harder because then they have a timer like with a bomb attached to it. Because of all the people on screen, it's going to be bad in later games, and if that's the case. This is on music.
The schematic indicates that door is locked from the inside.
That's all right. I never was one for the direct approach.
Well, because the indirect approach is way up there through that air vent.
This is some club music right here. I'm gonna fight these rats though. First treasure that you can sell. There's the safe.
It took some higher level math, but I believe the code to Dimitri's vault is 231.
That was the code to the last one. Hey. Ooh, I'll take it. Thank you. And thank you. Heads or tails? I think that trophy's for again, but let's go here and put that on. Nice little smoke bomb. Remote trigger. Yep. Fill that meter up so I don't waste it.
Clear for what?
Of that I'm uncertain. ring the bell and follow him without being seen. Then maybe we'll find out what he's hiding.
Like these little idle movements that you can have when the character stands still, like Sly, like scratches back with his cane or flips his hat back on. Oh, yeah, this might be a little scary for y'all, because it scared me when I was a kid. Whenever this fucker pops out of nowhere, I go, Jesus! Fucking look at that face! He's the only one that gets that kind of intro, too. None of the other ones get anything like that. I gotta do it because I love his reaction.
Keep it smooth, baby.
Smokey alert! Freak out!
Smokey alert! Like, what does that mean? Smokey alert. Smokey alert! Freak out! That music plays when he's going around. This guy, dude.
Oh, stand tall, you funky. Juice. Take art. Be art. Got to keep it smooth.
Talks to himself a lot more than I remember.
Keep it smooth, baby.
God! Bastard turned around. Get out of the way, you fucking
thing. Aha.
Good job tailing him, Sly. He had no idea you were watching while he typed in that secret code. Hold on. Looks like that door leads to the nightclub's aqua pump. Might be useful for the heist.
Murray job, eh?
This is a job for Murray. Come back to the safe house to switch characters.
This poor guy. Help me out here. Finally plays Murray, which is kind of cool, but just look at him. So fucking, like, out of shape, but you can still pack a punch. Pick up shit too and throw it. Damn. Fucking flatten that car.
To get past these lasers.
You should be able to break that power box by throwing something at it. Press the circle button to use your stomp move near the ice machine to pick up a block of ice. Then press the square button to throw the block at the power box.
Hit the circle button to pick stuff up and the square button to throw. Got it.
Poor bastards. That's fucking murder right there.
Okay, fellas, I've constructed a plan to get at the clockwork tail feathers, but we'll need to pull off a few more jobs to set things up for the heist. First, Sly will have to pick a few pockets in the theater so that we'll have access to the spotlight control center. Once that's accomplished, we'll be able to turn off all the security around the printing press. We'll need your muscle, Murray, to take out all the exterior alarm horns. We don't want anything to alert the guards while we pull off the big job. And finally, we'll need to get into the discotheque to drop this mirror ball. Trust me, it's all part of the plan.
Hold it, Cooper.
Constable Neela. Another policewoman hot on my tail.
Please, I led you here.
So that Claw Gang slip was a clue. Why are you helping me out?
I'm not as black and white as Carmelita. I know what a menace those clockwork parts are, and I don't want the likes of the Claw Gang putting them to use.
So what? It takes a thief to catch a thief?
Something like that. But if I'm going to trust you in this case, I need to know that you can keep up. Literally.
Literally?
Don't fall behind.
Fly, hold down the R1 button to run. You'll need it to keep up with Constable Neela. Heads up, if you leave this area, you'll abandon your current job.
Don't leave in the area, shut up.
Well done, Sly. We should work well together.
Glad you approve.
Now, legally, I can't enter Dimitri's nightclub without a warrant. But I happen to have obtained a key to his back door, which a person like yourself can use however he pleases.
Oh, we are absolutely going to work well together.
That job inside the disco will require my demolition. Head on back to the safe house. I should be all geared up for the field by the time you arrive. If you can get this piece of fine art back to the safe house in one piece,
shit,
we can sell it on ThieveNet for a ton of coins.
Oh no. Getting greedy here, but oh boy. There's Murray, then we'll play as Bentley. Then we'll end it with Sly.
Okay, Murray. That alarm horn will tip off Dimitri during our heist. There are three of them out here, and I need you to take them out.
Check!
This is going to take some serious muscle, Murray. You're the only guy on the team who can pull this off. Stop to pick things up, then throw it at those alarm horns. Good luck, pal. This could get rough.
Evildoers feel my wrath.
Oh.
Oh boy. This is a cool ability. Instantly kills people. Even flashlight guards instantly die to a hit from this. They could all die to any element, even like electricity and other stuff like that. I'm trying to find a flashlight guard to hit. There we go. He's got bombs galore. And they are powerful bombs, but they're also very hard to use. He drops them. Well, I could throw them too, because I bought the upgrade, but other than that, it'd be a pain in the ass. Also, he's limited in his movements. Thurgame gets a lot better movement, but you'll see why.
Okay, Bentley. To get past the laser fence, you'll need to blow it up. Press the triangle button to drop a bomb, and then get out of the way before it explodes. Good job. Now, use your sleep darts to get by the guard. Press the R3 button, you know, click the right analog stick, to bring up your binoculars. And then tap the R1 button to fire a dart. He's out. Drop a bomb on him while he's down to keep him that way. Hey, Bentley, how you holding up out there in the field?
Fine, I'm just fine. I just need to bomb all the pillars supporting that disco ball and I can get out of here.
What's with taking out the disco ball?
Its impact will shake the nightclub's front peacock sign loose from its mooring. Look, I can't talk. Now I've got to keep moving. Keep safe.
Still nervous as shit. sure you guys can hear that little static in here. It's kind of pissing me off. That was fucking annoying. Like fucking static and going on. Jesus Christ. Fucking neck. His teeth are sticking out when you do that too. Fucked up his mouth in this game. There's another one by that disco club. Might as well grab that and sell it while I'm at it. There's one over here somewhere, right behind here. Is that talent, I think? There's one over here somewhere. No! Damn it. can't find only two treasures. There's more, isn't there?
Sorry, Bentley, but those fans are spinning way too fast to walk on.
They can be slowed down from this control panel, but you'll have to do a lot of pickpocketing to get at it. The guards are carrying special fragile keys that will be destroyed if you attack. Make sure you pickpocket their keys before you take those thugs out. To pickpocket guards, sneak up behind them and press the circle button.
Check one, check two. Son, Dimitri on the mic with a shout out to all my nightclub samurai. Stand tall and feel beautiful. I hear some raccoon dude giving a static. If you all spot this cracker box, bam! Bing! Kill unhappy. Take no prisoners. Go hardcore. Extreme all over his face.
What?
Okay, peace out.
What do you say? Go hardcore extreme all over his face. Okay, peace out. Dude, can't think of what you just said there. That sounded really fucking sus. He's sleeping with his eyes open?
Nice work, Sly. Now head for the control panel to slow down the fans. Overriding the the spotlight security guns. That should do it. No more security in the printing press room.
Okay, fellas, the dominoes are all in place. Time to pull off the big heist.
Thunderbeak.
First, Murray will help me break into the old water tower. From there, I should be able to shut down the plaza fountain. Dimitri's sure to send someone out to get the repair truck. Sly, you'll pickpocket the truck keys off this guy once he shows up, then hand them off to me and Murray in the plaza. We'll go steal the truck while you climb to the top of the nightclub's peacock sign. When you're in position, Murray will fire the truck's winch line up to you and will use it to pull down the sign. If my calculations are correct, the impact should create an entrance to the printing press room. Then, Sly, you jump in, grab the clockwork tail feathers, and we all get the heck out of here.
Let's do it then. Nothing to sell. Please bet we can start this one up, doesn't it? Yeah, bet. Operation Thunderbeak.
Chum, let's get to that water tower.
This music's awesome, by the way.
You up there.
Oh, shit.
You're gonna have to blast your way in.
To focus. Which valves do I turn to divert water pressure from the plaza? To change the flow of water through a valve, I should press the circle button.
Got it. Thank you.
Success!
Easy.
It's off all right. They're already sending out the repair guy to fix it up.
Pickpocket the keys to his repair truck without being seen.
Hey, fellas.
It's all you.
Let's head out for the repair truck. Take the wheel. I know how to drive a stick ship.
How can you fit in there? What the hell?
I need to get in position on top of the nightclub's peacock sign for phase three. In position.
Great. We're just driving up right now. Get ready to grab the tow harpoon.
Oops. Too short.
Dang.
Hooks on. Pull away.
Sly, the guards are onto us. Protect the truck. Behold the majesty of gravity and inertia.
That was real subtle, Bentley.
Okay, you jump in, grab the clockwork tail feathers, and we're out of here.
This right totally bumming my house up and bringing me down so very uncool. Why can't you let birds and bees be free, bro?
Listen, Dimitri, you have no idea what you're playing with. It'll bring more than your house down.
Look, bro, I see you are a tough cowboy, a man with taste, style, vision, a connoisseur of finer things like me. Look, I'm sure the two cats in a bag like us can work something out. Yeah, we smooth. Look, see the money. You like the money. You can take all you want. I can.
No deal. You and the rest of the Claw Gang have to be stopped. Clockwork will never again see the light of day. Just hand over the tail feathers and we can...
What is this with clocks, bro? Have you no vision? Are you hearing what I mean to you? You think you have juice? Don't show me a little mind when talking about such big things. You think you can swing the bat? Show your bling and let me shine you.
I have no idea what you're saying. And your suit sucks.
Let's dance!
And your suit sucks. Got your ass, bitch. Ooh. Ouch.
You take clockwork feathers and my counterfeit in operation. It's past tense.
I'm doing you a favor. What kind of thief prints money? There's no honor in that.
You... Crackerbox!
Crackerbox. Oh yeah. What a start. I like that I'll detail the book too.
My gang and I had done it. The clockwork tail feathers were ours, and Dimitri's counterfeiting operation was ruined. Due to the untimely arrival of Carmelita, my escape got a little tricky. Angry at having just missed me, she took it out on Dimitri, shutting down the nightclub and throwing the frustrated forger behind bars. The gang and I headed out of town for a week in Monaco. I figured the team had earned themselves a well-deserved break.
That got censored for some fucking reason, or got cut off. What's supposed to happen is, it's supposed to be that the gang and I headed out for a week in Monaco and Bentley wanted to try out some new card formula thing that he came up with, and they're playing a card game, throws down like some number card, and I guess he wins because the Murray gets all surprised, and that's when Sly says, and I figured the team earned themselves a well-deserved break. They cut it out for some fucking reason. I have no idea why, but that's 100% right there. It took me about, was it a minute? A minute? That's no way. It's an hour, I think. This is episode 2. But I think I'll end it here for now. And should I start the next one? Fuck it. Yeah, I'll start another one after this. But we'll do a stream end here. I'll have the episode upload, and then we'll be back for the next one. So till then, I'll see you guys in a bit.